Hello everybody. The goal of this course is to reach a perspective of the work inspections at the construction process in order to get the quality in building. That's the summary of the course, but today's topic is going to be focused in columns as a part of the reinforced concrete structure. I would like to show you the main activities we should take to follow and run this unit. First of all, we would like to start by the diamond circle principles that will help to us to get our scope. Plan, do, check, act. We should start from the project management, just run the work construction on site and check all the activities inside. In case of any failure, damage or not conformities, just do the report. The project details will give to us all the information we will need to make the construction in the columns unit. Details as the characteristics of the rebars, the positions, the kind of steel or the ties and the separation between each tie. Of course, the borders and the specific positions of the pillars in the intermediate levels on the top level of the building. Of course, the table, the plans with the specifications of the rebars will give to us all the information about the number of pillar or columns, the section, if it is a square section or circular section, the dimensions, the size and diameter of the rebars, and all the details we will need to make the reinforcement and the construction of the columns. During the materials reception, we should check and we should be very careful where we are going to store our reinforcement and the work site. So putting on directly to the subsoil will increase our future rusting in our casing. In this case, we can see the casings with a lot of rusty in the surface. We should check if this rusty is adherent or not, and if it is going to be bad for the future adherency with the concrete. In case of not, just remove these cases and ask it for a new ones. During the material reception, we should also check if all the identifications, all the sticks that these cases are holding in, are in correspondence with the specifications from our plans. In the layout, we should check the position. So these anchor bars who are coming from the foundation or maybe from the intermediate level should be in the right position and should have the correspondence with the layout. When we are making the chocks with these blue lines in the surface of the horizontal structure, we should review if the position is okay. So right here we can see the layout, which it is not in correspondence with the prior column. Here the position is not right, the minimum distance from the rebars are not enough from the mandatory normative, and of course the length of the anchor bolts are not enough, there is possible rusty, and maybe the worst not conforming here in this picture is just the head of the pillar is passing through the horizontal element, and it is not right because it should be just stop in the bottom in the inside face of the horizontal element. The ground connections should be right now connected to with all the bars and the reinforcement in this unit. And the reinforcement should keep the position of the rebars from the future forms. Here we can see the detail of the distance, the minimum distance that we will be helping by the spacers to keep the covering in all the rebars in our columns. In the reinforcement also we should make this clark, this layouting in the surface to keep the position the right position and the final dimension of our pillar or column. During the reinforcement, sometimes we have to match or link different activities. In this picture, we can see the detail of the pillar, the column, but of course we can see also the beginning of the reinforcement in this retaining wall. During the reinforcement, we are not going to have any problem, but check the activity because sometimes we have to make a special modification in the form's position to include the both elements at the same time. In the reinforcement, we should keep also the plumb. To plumb the reinforcement, to plumb the case is very relevant in order to don't have any slope in inclination in the future position of our column. Of course, we can correct it during the phone's position where we will put it inside the spacers. But it's so much better if from the beginning it is well collocated and the plumb is right and correctly done. During the reinforcement, we should check also if the case is done in a factory, it should be certified, but in case you do it on work, take care about if the rebars are well connected with the anchor bolts, the new bars and the ties, who should be in the right distance who is marked in the project. Yeah, this is the detail of the spacers or separators we are going to use. Could be circular, could be square, depending on the factory and the providor. And in all cases, will help to us to keep the covering of the pillar with the concrete. During the formwork, we should prime with a special resin to avoid the future adherence between the formworks and the concrete. Then we can start preparing the pieces depending of the kind of the system we are going to use, depending of the providor, and just putting on the right position. Depending of the formworks and the material we are using, we will putting on the pieces, the works, the formworks in different positions. Right here we can see this is a small one, and the standard form led to us to have a bigger sizes, right? Following all the chocks we have marking in the floor, we can put in on the formwork and start with the final shape. When we finish this, we should check if all is in the right position and if the covering around the reinforcement around this casing is completely well done. We can see with the spacers and the separators who are keeping the final distance and the final position and dimension of our column. During the formwork, also we have to be careful in case of using circular formworks because they have a special difficulties in each matchmaking. During the formwork, also after to use a prefabricated elements, we can also fix a formwork, a vertical formwork, to keep it in the plumb position during its pouring. And right now we are ready to start with the concrete pouring. In the materials reception, check the temperature, temp the characteristics, temp the time the concrete is inside the track, and check if all the certification and the characteristics who are mandatory are well done. Then we can do the concrete test, just send it to the laboratory with a notified laboratory, please. And also we are ready to concrete pouring our element. Using a pipe or using a trimmer, it doesn't matter, just control the maximum length from the head of the element and the area where the concrete is going out, because in case of extreme high we can separate the aggregates from the cement, which is not good, and we will reduce our future resistance. After to pouring our whole column, just please check the level, check the plumb, and correct any possible mistake. Reject the pillar, reject the column if it is not well done. During the formwork stripping, we should check if the time, the minimum time which is mandatory, is well down. And remember, the time is depending of the weather condition and so many circumstances. So check it in the project management and get started with your formwork stripping. During the stripping, we should check just the cleaning of the surface of the formworks, and you are ready for the curing. This curing is not completely curing as we understand in horizontal surfaces, because it's not directly done after to pouring the concrete, it's after. But anyway, it keeps the temperature, it keeps the moisture in the pillar in the column, and it's very good for to reduce the future crashes in the surfaces. As a final check, take a look if you have a lot of holes, if you have any damage in your pillar. Don't be scared about this. This is just simple quantity of cement and water. And in the final check, just be careful. If your plumbing is not well done, you will have this. And of course, you will have to reject this column and repeat it. If everything is well done, just continue with the next step, next stage. If not, just document your reject your report and just identify what it's not well done and why you should repeat it. Thank you very much for your attention.